Hey guys, what is up and welcome back to another review video where today I've got something big here. Yes, it is a Samsung LED 27-inch monitor and basically I use this for gaming. And yeah, I just got it not that long ago. I've had probably about a week of use with it. And so yeah, I'm actually really enjoying it, but you guys are probably here because you want to see the review on it. But basically some of the simple specs on it, it's 27 inches. It's a rectangular kind of shape dealio going on here. It's a 1920 by 1080, and I'll pop up a picture of what the back looks like, because if you go on the back, it's a little hard to see there. But yeah, I'm sure there's a picture going up right now on what it looks like. But yeah, so I just use this for my Xbox One. It has an HDMI in the back, and I know it has some other ports for computers and stuff. But the main thing I was concerned about is it doesn't have an audio cable, so it was kind of a process getting the audio to work. What you have to do is, it's like a thing with the Xbox One. I'm sure you guys can look up a video on how to get it, but yeah, it was kind of a hassle to get the audio working on this, but it does work. You can get your Xbox One to work with it. I have mine. I know my setup isn't too good right now. I have my speakers just like in the back there because my desk isn't quite big enough for everything quite yet. But yeah, so just the design, let me go over it real quick. My camera doesn't quite show the color here, but it has like a really nice just matte white on there, and it's got like a kind of bluish outline there, and then it goes all the way down at the bottom, and then down here they've got their Samsung right there, and then they've got this kind of big dish looking thing that that keeps it very sturdy, and it does lean a little bit forward, but it's supposed to be like that, I think. And then it's very minimal, like, getting it set up, as you guys can see here. Let me see, like, that. The actual monitor and then this little stand piece right here is actually two different parts. It's one screw. It's very easy. It was so easy. Like, it wasn't even a problem. Screwed it in, popped it down, put in my HDMI, and it worked very quickly. I got it set up in probably, like, 20 minutes or so. But yeah, the audio was a little bit of an issue because it doesn't have like one of those 3.5 millimeter audio cable things. But yeah, you can just look up a video on how to get it. It's not too difficult. You just need like an extra cord and stuff. But yeah, so I'm not sure how this would work with a computer, but it does have a port for here. It's like behind the HDMI there that you can plug into your computer. I'm sure it would work with Mac and stuff, but yeah, and then it's really cool. Way down here, if you guys can see that, it's a little hard to see, but basically all you have to do to turn it on, you just slide it right over, turns on, and then I'm actually on my Xbox One here. Now, it's not getting the full quality of the picture because my camera isn't the best, but it's really sharp. Like, I wasn't expecting it to be that sharp. And some cool features about this monitor. All the stuff is down here. There's a gaming mode, and then to just do that, you just slide it. Sometimes that takes a little bit. Yeah, and then that little menu bar comes up. Gaming mode, click it once, and I don't know if you guys saw that, but it got just a little bit brighter, and the colors get a little, like, sharper and stuff like that. But, here, I'll demo that one more time here. You just go like that, or just slide over the menu or something like that, and then see how the gaming mode is on and off. So it just gets a little darker. And then there's also a brightness setting. So then you can just easily bring it down if you want, or up. So it's pretty easy. And then there's contrast, go down, and then I'm not gonna mess with it too much, but if you wanted the contrast to be different and stuff like that, move it back up to 75 where it was, and then to get it all the way, just go like that. So yeah, it's all touchscreen. There's no like actual buttons, but yeah, I just got it, so I'm not too used to how this stuff works. But yeah, I usually just keep it on normal. The gaming mode is cool, but I don't know, maybe I will have it on here, turn on the gaming mode there. Yeah, it just gets a little bit brighter. And yeah, the colors just get deeper and stuff like that. So it's definitely a cool feature if you're going to be using this for gaming, which I really recommend. It's I think 27 inches is such a good like size for gaming. So yeah, it's definitely a gaming monitor, I'd say. And then I just have a comparison to my Mac here. Oh gosh, the colors are weird. But yeah, it goes good with Mac, I think. And like how the Macs are white as well. And yeah, for thinness, it's not too incredibly thin, but it's thin enough where it's not like bulky or anything. But yeah, as you guys can see, it's a great monitor. I'm really enjoying it. I looked at quite a few different monitors, and this seemed like a really good one. And it's when I was looking for mine, I was definitely looking for a thinness there. It's not too bad. Here, I'll show you guys in the comparison, like with my finger. It's like about as thick as your finger, unless you have like huge fingers or I don't know. But about as thick as your finger, and it's. It's just an overall really good monitor. If you guys have any questions, just leave them down in the comments, and I'll also link the Samsung thread on there. And I think that'll be it for this video. If you guys did enjoy, please do leave a like and subscribe if you haven't already. And stay tuned for more review videos and gameplay stuff, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.